Hi, and welcome to another episode of Florida Sport Fishing Television for the Avid Angler. We're just leaving Hillsboro Inlet here, early fall morning. Looks like we got some nice conditions. We're going kite fishing. Hopefully we'll encounter a couple of sailfish, maybe some dolphin. The bite's been challenging lately, but we're going. We've got a live well full of bait, got the whole crew on board. Stay with us, let's see if we get hooked up.
You're watching Florida Sport Fishing, television for the avid angler.
Another one on!
Whoa, nice!
One in the boat.
What an absolutely awesome experience. We've got a perfectly rigged lure, and we're going fishing. Just running down a little bit here, looking for some fishy water. Saw a couple of birds, a little bit of scattered weed. A couple fish crashed some bait up on the surface. Got a big rain cell coming up the beach here, so we're just moving south just a little bit. See if we can find some fishy water, a distinct edge, anything that's going to attract bait, in turn attract sailfish, dolphin, any of the other game fish that are around. And that's the whole key, you know, is really paying attention to what's going on around you, being well prepared. Don't just stop anywhere and think you're gonna catch fish. You've gotta really key in on particular locations that will potentially hold bait, and again, hold the fish that you're looking for. Just got set up here right outside of Hillsboro Inlet. We've been fishing maybe 5 minutes, still getting the kite baits up. Would you have a pilchard on that rod or a gog?
Donkey gog.
Big goggle eye. Our first sailfish in the morning, just crushes bait, fishing a light 20 pound outfit. Yeah, it's really exciting catching them on this kind of gear. You know, you certainly can come out with 50 pound class tackle, but you don't need it. You don't need it for these sailfish. You know, they average really 30 to 60 pounds, and 20 or 30 pound class tackle, either conventional or spinning gear, is all that you need to tackle these fish. But again, you just finesse fishing, you've got to take your time. As you can see with Boone, he's not horsing the fish. He's not forcing it. You know, we know that fish is still hot. He's got a lot of energy. Yep, still going. That's really the whole key with sailfish and his teamwork. As you can see, we got Steve up here. He's in the bow, getting a couple baits out on the kite. We're trying to turn one bite into two bites. You know, very likely there's more fish right in this area right here. So we're hoping to get another fish on here. Yeah, well, when he sees the boat, he's gonna freak, but he is coming. You're getting close. Nice fish, maybe 40, 50 pounds. Got him? Oh, no, he's going under the boat. There he is, there you go. Hold that rod way out under the boat. You don't want that line to touch the boat. If that line touches the bottom of that boat, that fish is gone instantly. Really, really a crucial time. When that fish is right up next to the boat, you've got, there he is right there. Look at that, absolutely awesome sailfish. I'm gonna reach down, grab him by the bill. There you go, it'll come around one more time. Hook right there. No, got him. All right, nice job. Look at that. And look at that circle hook. Let me show you that. Talk about wrapped right around his bill. And look at that, absolutely no harm to that fish whatsoever. Didn't even know it was hooked. Oh, what an absolutely gorgeous fish. Still all lit up, nice and silvery. His fins are all colorful and blue. Look at that. Hello, Mr. Sailfish. Don't worry, pal, I'm gonna let you go. Yes. I know, it's gorgeous, dude. Look at that bill. And they just, they come up on prey and they swipe at it with that sharp bill right there. You know, they don't stab prey, but they'll swipe at it, they'll wound it. Okay, pull them up real quick here. Look at that, gorgeous fish. We don't want to touch them too much and we certainly don't want to rub them up on the gunnels. But that's a beautiful, beautiful South Florida sail right there. That's what it's all about, baby. Get yourself some of that.
This fish could come off at any second. This is really critical right here.
Florida Sport Fishing is proudly presented by Bionic Bait. Fish prefer Bionic Bait. Veruno, trusted by professionals in every ocean. Ghost, boat tracking, security, monitoring, and surveillance you can count on. Boat Insurance Florida, save up to 50% on boat insurance. Marine Survival Technologies, make safe boating your number one priority. Florida Sport Fishing Magazine, your number one resource for the latest tips, tricks, tactics, and techniques. For inshore and off. Only $30 for 3 years. For immediate home delivery, log on to floridasportfishing.com. Enter promo code TV and receive a free shirt with paid subscription.
The secret's out. Start with brine and bite, the only brine that infuses proven bite stimulants into any rigged bait. Procure badass bait dyes are next, and bring Ballyhoo to life with vibrant fluorescent colors. Seal the deal with Procure's new Bloody Tuna Oil and watch your catch ratio soar. Inshore and offshore, Procure bait scents and badass bait dyes keep you hooked up. Find Procure at your favorite dealer or call 800-PROCURE for a free catalog.
Chaos is tragic. Chaos can be awesome.
Yo, another one on! Three on, baby!
With Chaos Fishing, it's your rod your way. Quality components and personalized service from a legendary builder equal the right rod at the right price every time. Shop online for a complete selection of serious fishing equipment. Or visit Chaos's new superstore and receive a free t-shirt with every rod purchase. Chaos Fishing, gear matters.
100, 500, 1,000. How much money are you wasting on melted ice and thawed bait? Frigid Rigid keeps ice and bait frozen for 10 days. Built to withstand everyday use, 25 sizes up to 525 quarts means there's a Frigid Rigid cooler, refrigerator, or tackle center just for you. The boat may have burnt down, but the ice and chum stayed frozen. Frigid Rigid, 800-643-1988, or visit frigidrigid.com for a dealer near you.
Thank you for watching Florida Sport Fishing, television for the avid angler.
The king.
Good job. There he goes, there he goes. There's a screamer.
Grab it!
Wow. That's a wahoo. That is a wahoo. Boone, bring that gaff up here. That was a bite. That was a good bite. He's got wire in that too.
This one's hooked right in the corner with a circle hook, so. Well, I haven't come off yet. No, I'm good right here. Should be close. He took a lot of line, but it's not too far. I hope that's a wahoo. There's some big kings around though. I saw one in the sky. Yeah, I see color. I got about a 10-foot leader right here. Wow, he just took off again. Shaking his head. I don't like that with his mono. He's got to be hooked perfectly. And this fish could come off at any second. This is really critical right here. Here we go. About a 15, 10 pounder maybe, 10 pounds. Perfect hook set right in the corner. Look at that.
How about that gaff shot?
Perfect.
That'll smoke.
That'll be on the smoker.
You guys get him?
Yeah.
Nice.
Perfect, right in the corner of the mouth.
Yeah, with that circle.
Uh-huh.
There he is right there, Carlos. Nice king. Nice king. Just got another fish on here on a deep rod. This is why it's so important when you're kite fishing to fish the entire water column. We've got a couple of deep baits and picking away at some kings in between sail bites. Hooked up on a spinner. I told you you can catch him in this green water. Dude, that fish went ballistic. Was that on another gog or a pilchard?
That was on a big pilchard.
Big pilchard.
A big half dead thing.
190 feet, we got into some green water here. A little bit of a color change. Didn't look too promising, but lo and behold, boom, another sailfish. 20 pound spinner.
Oh, there he goes.
There he goes. 7 foot Chaos composite rod. Daiwa 6500 Saltese reel loaded with 20 pound diamond high catch. 50 pound fluorocarbon leaders, presentation leader from Diamond Fishing Products. 7-0 circle hook, laser sharp. It's that simple, it really is. You know, we're always telling you to look for that blue edge, for that clean blue water. Here we are, drifted into some pea soup green water. And lo and behold, nice sailfish.
I was trying to fix another rod up there, and eyelet broke, and sure enough, this one got smoked, had a big pilchard on it, and that sail just came up right next to the boat and crushed it.
Right up on top, no weight?
No weight.
That's the key with these circle hooks. The less you do, the better your hookup ratio. You know, the fish is gonna come up, he's gonna crush that bait, he's gonna swim away.
Let him hook himself.
Let him hook himself. The reel's locked up, you're gonna get him right in the corner of the mouth. You saw one earlier this morning, was hooked right in the bill. Absolutely no harm to these fish. And that's what's really important, you know, together as an angling community, we can make a difference. Please send your donations to my...
Boone at floridasportfishing.com.
Whoa, is that your fish? Holy cow, dude.
Pro's Tip, brought to you by the Florida Keys and Key Largo. A world away, come as you are.
Hi, and welcome to this episode's Pro's Tip. Today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about sea anchors. Really an important tool when you're live bait fishing, regardless if you're tournament fishing or just out for a weekend of fun. It's really an essential tool when you're fishing live baits, when you're kite fishing. And there's a couple of key reasons why we use these sea anchors. Some guys call them parachutes, drift socks. I like to call it a sea anchor. Number one, make sure you use the appropriate size sea anchor for your size boat. Obviously, the larger boat is going to require a larger sea anchor, upwards of 15 feet or more. So the right size is very important. Number two, how that sea anchor is fastened to your boat is also crucial. Sea anchors, you know, really put a tremendous amount of stress on the cleat as that boat is rocking, especially when it's rough. So you want to make sure that that line that's connecting that sea anchor to the boat is strong enough to withstand those stresses. Also make sure that your cleat is capable of withstanding those stresses. Make sure you have enough scope, enough line between that sea anchor and your cleat. That's also very important, as well as a trip line. And this is probably the most important part of the entire sea anchor right here. What this trip line does is it trips it. It pulls the sea anchor from the back. And now as I pull this, as you can see, it's bringing in that sea anchor right from the back. Look at that. It just collapsed it. Very, very easy to bring right aboard. You need that trip line because it's nearly impossible to pull in that full sea anchor, that full parachute filled with water is very, very challenging. So you need that trip line. Why do we fish these sea anchors? Why do we use them? A couple of different reasons. Number one, it slows down our drift, and that's really, really important. If we know that the bulk of the action is taking place between 100 and 200 feet, we're gonna deploy that sea anchor and it's gonna slow our drift. It's gonna allow us to fish that avenue, that strike zone methodically and intentionally, and really be able to take advantage of anything in that strike zone. So slowing us down certainly is very, very important. Number two, and equally as important, it'll hold our boat parallel to the sea conditions. The wind is right in my face here. If we didn't have the sea anchor out, you know, the boat may not be behaving the way you would like it to. You may end up with lines that are in a tangle. Here we can fish 4, 6, 8, sometimes even more lines right down the side of the boat. This is a 37 strike, a big walk around, but regardless of what boat you're fishing, or if it's a center console, you've got the ability to fish a lot of baits, but you wanna make sure that that presentation is really, really spot on. That's what's important. And that sea anchor is gonna allow you to do that. It'll allow you to get as many baits as you can out away from the boat without tangling, and you'll have a super, super presentation. If you're serious about live bait fishing, if you're serious about kite fishing, you absolutely need a sea anchor.
Pro's Tip, brought to you by the Florida Keys and Key Largo. A world away, come as you are.
When the bite's on, the last thing you want is contaminated fuel. Ethanol creates sludge, damages fuel systems, and starves engines. Protect any gasoline or diesel engine with Formula X2. Independent testing proves Formula X2 eliminates water, cleans, and lubricates. See it for yourself. For only pennies per gallon, Formula X2 provides complete protection and maximum performance for any engine. Order now at FormulaX2.com.
YachtLights.com. Everything marine lighting. Interior and exterior. YachtLights.com has it all at the lowest prices. Stylish recessed lights, LED strips, floodlights and deck lights, and the hottest underwater lights from as low as $199. Shop online for free shipping and weekly clearance items, or visit our new showroom. When you need marine lighting, you need YachtLights.com.
you can hear this transmission, you are part of the resistance and you are not alone. We are outnumbered but not outsmarted. We are taking Florida back in the streets, in the air, in the water, and we have infiltrated the airwaves. We know you're tired and looking for a better taste, so you must join the fight. We have the answer. It's in your DNA. DNA energy drink. We are the revolution.
Tired of outrageous markups? Stingray Fishing Outfitters beats all advertised prices with specials on the finest tournament-winning tackle, accessories, and outdoor apparel. Operated by knowledgeable anglers, with everything you need for freshwater and saltwater fishing under one roof, ready for immediate delivery. Save big. Shop where the pros shop. Shop at stingraytackle.com.
Is kicking my butt.
Whoa, was that your fish? Holy cow, dude.
He's still going ballistic out there. Let's go get this thing. Strong fish. Things got me sweating.
Straight up and down?
Yeah, straight up and down.
How's that arm feeling, that right arm?
I haven't worked with sailfish muscle in a while.
We'll work this fish up and then we're gonna slide to the stern and try and get her upright in the stern. Steve, our kite guy, jumped in with his camera gear. He's gonna get some really awesome underwater footage of this fish. Give you a fisheye perspective of this sailfish right under the surface. Really, really cool. Nice, nice. That's it. Nice! That's a release.
Got him?
Got him. Good job. Look at it. Look, he's still so alive. Look at that. So strong. Awesome. Absolutely awesome. Wait. I should be able to just wedge it right out. There it is. Right there. Look at that. He's so frisky. Ready to go. Go. Money. Money. Woo! Nice. Awesome, we had a diver in the water following that fish as she swam away. She put up a great fight on a light tackle spinner. As you can see right behind me here, that's Hillsboro Inlet Lighthouse right there. We're literally minutes outside of our inlet. We're really fortunate here in South Florida to have such extraordinary sail fishing, bill fishing, world class, just minutes from the inlet right here. We're really, really privileged and we can never take that for granted. There's a lot of great fisheries down here, but the sail fishing in the wintertime picks up around late October, November, just continues to heat up. By February, it's completely on fire. Any day you can come out here, score double digit releases. It's awesome. It was a boat last year, had 50 something releases in one day, just to the north of us. I mean, where else in the world can you experience sail fishing like that? Especially here in the Atlantic, nowhere. South Florida is the place. Let's go get set back up and catch a couple more.
Got a bite.
Whoa, right there on the kite bait. Frustrated? Fish, ballyhook, cap gun trolling move.
That's money.
Tournament winning.
That is money. Oh, look at him taking it.
Jets, bullets, feathers, chuggers. the most effective high-speed wahoo lures on earth. Handcrafted in the U.S. and sold professionally rigged. Not sure what to pull? Call for expert advice.
Wow, another one on, another one on!
I troll Ballyhood lures because they work.
The secret's out. Start with brine and bite, the only brine that infuses proven bite stimulants into any rigged bait. Procure badass bait dyes are next, and bring Ballyhoo to life with vibrant fluorescent colors. Seal the deal with Procure's new Bloody Tuna Oil and watch your catch ratio soar. Inshore and offshore, Procure bait scents and badass bait dyes keep you hooked up. Find Procure at your favorite dealer or call 800-PROCURE for a free catalog.
Florida Sport Fishing is proudly presented by Fishing Pursuits. Visit fishingpursuits.com and go fish the planet. Unique species, release mounts for every trophy catch. Liquid Light, see what you've been missing. EC Rider, marine-grade beanbags built for fishermen. Rodan, precision GPS-guided trolling motors. Gear Guide, brought to you by Diamond Fishing Products, the most reliable monofilament and braided fishing line in the world.
Often overlooked, coolers play a huge role in our boating and fishing experiences and contribute greatly to our enjoyment on the water. For passenger comfort, it's all about keeping food and beverages cold and refreshing, as no one likes a soggy sandwich or warm beer. For anglers, coolers keep our bait fresh and, more importantly, keep our precious catch in prime condition. With that being said, not all coolers are created equal. So if you are passionate about our sport, then it's time to make a serious investment in a quality product from a leading manufacturer. A real cooler will cost more, but it's imperative equipment that will potentially last a lifetime. First and foremost, stay away from cheap plastic. Those off-the-shelf coolers on sale at the local superstore are basically disposable and will rarely make it more than a few seasons before they begin to fall apart. Rather, look for durable, molded coolers with corrosion-resistant hinges, heavy-duty handles, and a commercial-grade rubber gasket. Equally as important is the level of insulation. 2 inches or more is a must for maximum ice-keeping abilities. Anything less, and prepare to watch your money melt away. Capacity must also be considered, as there's no need to bring along a 150-quart cooler if yellowtail snapper are the target. On the flip side, when heading over the horizon for a weekend of wahoo trolling, a high-capacity cooler capable of keeping plenty of ballyhoo fresh and a dozen quality fish well iced is the right tool for the job. A few tips include avoiding empty airspace. Rather, load your cooler with bait and beverages and proceed to pack full of ice. This is especially true for extended trips. Only open the cooler when necessary, as each time the lid opens, all of the cold air escapes. Finally, keep the drain plug sealed as ambient air could begin melting the ice from the bottom up. Aren't you tired of throwing money away season after season? Purchasing a high-quality cooler with cushion will be one of the best investments you ever make.
Gear Guide, brought to you by Diamond Fishing Products, the most reliable monofilament and braided fishing line in the world.
Steve was feeding out these kites. Was that the long kite bait, Steve?
Came off.
Oh, popped off. Fortunately, we still have two baits right there in the strike zone. If there's any other fish swimming around with that, you know, if that was a king, that's what we think it was, a king mackerel, we may get another shot at another fish here. So Steve's fishing the goggle eyes on the kite. A little bit of a bigger bait, a little bit heavier, more effective, easier to present directly on the surface, and that's what you want. You want that bait fish swimming frantically right up on the surface. This way, any sort of game fish comes by, you know, it's gonna trigger that natural instinct to feed. That's a wounded prey item, and the fish have to eat it. It's instinct, they have to do it. But as you can see, he's constantly on that rod. He's constantly monitoring those baits. You know, he's making sure that that bait is right on the surface, and you've got to make minute adjustments. You know, he's adjusting the height of the kite. He's adjusting the height of the baits dangling from the kite. And again, those lines are going right up to release clips, very similar to an outrigger release clip. Fish comes up, crushes the bait. He tightens up, reels tight, pops out of the release clip, and now he's fighting that fish right from the rod tip. Check on our flat lines. We're fishing these flat lines, but if the fish comes up, sailfish comes up, he eats that goggle eye, he's gonna turn, he's gonna swim, you know, swim away, and hopefully that circle hook, it's fully exposed, it's gonna do its job, grab that fish right in the corner of the mouth. Line's gonna come screaming off the reel. Very easy, pick up the rod, reel tight, start fighting the fish. and you want to fish these baits properly, this is, you know, the difference of doing this is huge. A little rigging band right on the bend of the hook, very simple. Then take your little rigging needle, open end rigging needle, and put it right there. We're gonna take that needle right in that soft little tissue, right in front of its eyes, pull your loop through. That's it. You're gonna take your hook point into the rubber band, just like that, twist it a couple of times, go underneath the band, and that bait right there is perfectly bridled. That hook is affixed to the bait with that little rigging band right there. The bait's not wounded, I didn't dig a big hole in it, and now I'm gonna get that thing in the water as quickly as possible. Look how lively it is. Look at that, look at that. That's what you want right there. If you're gonna fish a live bait for sailfish, you want that bait to be frisky. Good job, Carlos. Get that fish on a gog.
Yep.
Switched it up, came off the kite, dropped a couple of goggle eyes down on some big wrecks. Fishing 200, 220 feet of water. And hooked up here. Again, you gotta keep your options open. You've gotta be ready to change it up on a dime and take advantage of any opportunity that might come your way. Pretty much wraps up another episode of Florida Sport Fishing. We'll see you at the weigh-in.
Florida Sport Fishing. Closed captioning provided by Navimatics. Quality navigation products for your iPad and iPhone. Pelagic Gear. Official provider of Florida Sport Fishing apparel. And Tropic Trailer. The largest equipment trailer dealer in Florida. Learn more about the tactics and techniques on today's show. Visit floridasportfishing.com and get hooked up. Florida Sport Fishing Magazine, your number one resource for the latest tips, tricks, tactics, and techniques for inshore and off. Only $30 for 3 years. For immediate home delivery, log on to floridasportfishing.com. Enter promo code TV and receive a free shirt with paid subscription.
Thank you for watching Florida Sport Fishing, television for the avid angler.